Hello dear students, welcome back and welcome in the biology session. And very warm good morning to all of you. So we are discussing our lesson, that is what? Crop production and management. In that already we have discussed some points. And now we have reached to the next point of the lesson, or that is what? Irrigation. That is nothing but what? The next steps in the agriculture practices. So in the previous video we have discussed about the fertilizers and manures. Okay, so we have said that we have discussed in that fertilizers and manures are very important to the plants. Okay, but if we talk about the manures and the fertilizers, among that the manures are the good for the plants and the fertilizers are somehow not good for the soil, which because excessive use of the fertilizers makes the soil infertile, lose the soil's fertility. Okay, and the one more point I want to add is that what the fertilizers are rich in specific nutrient. Okay, so that fertilizers are giving the certain types of the nutrients to the soil. We can say that NPK. Okay, so it will give the fertilizers which are rich in the NPK, means what? Nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Then by adding that NPK, we can increase the nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium in the soil. Okay, so in this way, if we talk about the manures, manures are not that much rich. It will take the more time to make the soil fertile as compared to the fertilizers. Okay, so all these things we have discussed in our lecture. So now we will move for the next steps today, or the next agriculture practice, that is nothing but what? Irrigation. Okay, so as we know, on the planet or on the earth, there are so many organisms, living organisms are there, and each and every living organisms need water for their proper survival. Okay, or to live the life properly, they require the water. Like the other human beings, or like all living things, we know that the plants are also living things. Okay, so obviously the plants will also require a water. Okay, so for the proper development, for the proper growth of the plant, the water is also necessary. And if we talk about the percentage of the water, then the plants contain the 90% of the water in their body. Okay, so there are the 90% of the water is present in a plant, or the plant contain nearly 90% of the water. So why is water is necessary for the plant? Why we have to give the water for the plant? Okay, so as we know, for the proper growth and the development, we are adding the fertilizers and the manures in the soil. Okay, but how it reach to the plant, or how it reach to the different parts of a plant? Okay, so let's see. So there are manures and fertilizers all get mixed into the water, or get dissolved into the water, and with the help of the water, that manures and the fertilizers and the different nutrients are transported to the different parts of a plant. Okay, so and with absorbing all that nutrients with the help of the water, so as we know, the roots are absorbing the water which contains the different nutrients and the minerals, and that water get transported to the different parts of a plant, and in this way the plant is getting the different types of the mineral, fertilizers and the manures. Okay, also why it is important, why we have to give the water to the plant? The very important thing is that germination of seed. Okay, so for the proper germination of the seed, the water is very important. Okay, so what are the favorable conditions for the germination? As we know that air, water and warm, these are the favorable conditions to get the seed germinate properly. So in that, water also plays a very important role for the germination of a soil. Okay, so if the water is not there, the seed will not get germinate properly. So for the proper germination, we have to give the water to the plants. Okay, next one is what? Nutrient dissolved in water are transported, that we have discussed the already, what? Whatever the nutrients are present in the water. Okay, so that all the water get absorbed by the roots and are get transported to the different parts of a plant. Okay, and in this way they are getting the different nutrients which are present in the soil. Also they are getting the fertilizers and manures in the same manner. Okay, so that fertilizers and manures and the minerals are getting mixed into the soil, and with the help of the water, whatever that minerals are present in the soil get mixed in the water, the roots absorb that water, and all that whatever nutrients, minerals, fertilizers are there, all are getting transported to the different parts of a plant. the next one. So with the help of all these water supply, we can maintain the proper growth and the development of a plant. Okay, and also the water helps the plant, or also the water protects the plant from the very hot climatic condition, or we can say the from the frost. Now frost means what? It is the weather condition in which what happens, the temperature of air or the air temperature falls below freezing point of the water, or in the short language or in the easy word, you can say that very extremely cold climatic condition. Okay, so with the help of these, or with the help of the water, the plants can protect itself, or the plants are getting protected from the frost and from the hot air currents. Okay, next one is there also to maintain the moisture in the soil. It is very important to provide the water for the soil. Okay, so if the soil will remain the moisture, or the if there will be the moisture in the soil, then only the growth of the plants, or the then only the growth of the crops will be proper. Okay, because why? Because if they will get the proper water, then only their development will happen. And also we know that for the production, or the for the synthesis of the photosynthesis, to synthesize their own food, the water is also the one raw material. Okay, so in this way, all these are the importance of the water, why the plants requires the water, and that is the reason at the regular interval of the time we should, or the farmers are providing the water, or they are providing the water to the field. Okay, so what? The supply of water to crops at regular intervals is called irrigation. Okay, so what is mean by irrigation? So this is the definition of the irrigation: supply of water to crops at regular interval. Regular intervals means after the certain period of the time. Okay, then that method is called as what? Irrigation. Okay, but this irrigation is get changed according to the soil, according to the season, and according to the crop to crop. Okay, so as you know, all the crops doesn't require the more amount of the irrigation. If you are taking the paddy crop, then obviously we have to give the more amount of the water. But as per, if we are not taking the paddy crop, if we are taking the another crop, okay, we can say that wheat crop is there, then we not, or the farmers are not required to provide the more amount of water. Okay, so the irrigation can change from crop to crop. Also it can change from soil to soil. Okay, so if the soil is different, according to the different types of the soil, the irrigation methods or the time intervals, or the how much time we have to irrigate the water is also get changed. And according to the season, the irrigation is also getting changed. Okay, so see, there is a winter season and a summer season. So if we think about it, in which season we have to provide the more water, or we have to give the frequently irrigation to the field? Yes, you are correct. Why? In the summer season, we have to give the more amount of the water to the field. Why? Because in the summer season, the weather condition is what? Hot, or the air temperature is rises, and because of that, what happens? The rate of the evaporation is also get increased. And as we know, from the leaves of a plant, the excessive water is getting thrown out from the plant with the help of the transpiration process. Okay, so the rate of the transpiration is getting increased during the summer season, and that is the reason during the summer season we have to provide the more amount of the water to the crop as compared to the winter season. Okay, so in this way, according to the crops, according to the season, and according to the soil, the irrigations are getting changed. Okay, so this is what all about irrigation. But from where we are getting this water, from which are the sources of the water, for that water we are using for the irrigation. So where we are getting the water for the irrigation? Let's see, that is what? Sources of irrigation. So there are the certain sources of the irrigation that are wells, tube wells, ponds, lakes, rivers, dams and canals. Okay, so all these are the sources of the irrigation. From all these, or from any one of these, the farmers are using the water to irrigate his crop. Okay, so this is all about today we have discussed about the irrigation, we have discussed about the importance of irrigation, also we have discussed about the sources of irrigation. So
time to tell you goodbye.
In the next video, we will.